إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، indeed the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، and the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها، and the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة، and everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة، and every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وكل ضلالة في النار، every going astray and every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, although this is a joyous day, a day that is supposed to be joyous and celebratory to all of us, I want us on this day to still carry a little bit of remorse, a little bit of sadness, a little bit of regret, and a little bit of a heavy heart, not just because we've exited the blessed month of Ramadan with no promise that we will see a Ramadan again, but because of the reality that we face as an ummah today. We have the book of Allah, huwa kitab Allah, al-mamdud min as-sama'i ila al-ard. We have the book of Allah, which is the words of Allah, outstretched from the heavens to the earth. Allah said, wa'qasimu bihablillahi jami'an wa la tafarraqu. Hold on tightly and cling to this book, so that you do not become divided, meaning all your basis goes back to the book of Allah. فَطَرَفُهُ بِيَدِ اللَّهِ وَطَرَفُهُ بِأَيْدِيكُمْ فَتَمَسَّكُوا بِهِ. One end of the rope of Allah is in his hand, the other end is in your hand. So cling tightly, firmly to it, so you do not go astray. We know this Quran that we've heard recited for the last month, that many of us picked up after a long time of not reading it and reflecting upon it, that this Quran is hudan linnas wa bayyinatin min al-huda wal-furqan. This is the book that is the guidance for mankind, with the clear proofs for that guidance and the criterion between right and wrong. This is the book, inna hadha al-Quran yahdi lillati hiya aqwam. This is the book of Allah, the speech of Allah, that will guide you to what is most right and what is most correct. Yet with all of this guidance toward what is true happiness and success, many of us will still fall on the Day of Judgment under those who abandoned and deserted this book, this final message to all of humanity, because we failed to implement it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, what means, and the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will say, oh my Lord, verily my people from this ummah deserted the Quran. They abandoned this Quran. They didn't listen to it. They didn't act upon it, its laws or its orders. The message of the Quran is clear. Ati'u Allah wa ati'u Rasul. Obey Allah and obey His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How the Sahaba radiallahu anhum wa ardahum did so. وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا. And be brothers and sisters in faith as servants to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in a very short surah what highlights the clear and straight path and the guidance to it. He says, وَالْعَصْرِ. He swears by time. And we have said many times, nobody swears by something that has no value. But time is of the greatest of values. It's priceless, and when a second passes, you can never get it back. So it is the most valuable of things. Allah then said, إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. Indeed, mankind is in a state of loss. They're in a state of loss because they have come to make their desires, their whims, their God, and worship their own selves and what they seek in this life, following their desires and whims, only caring about themselves. Everything is me, me, me. I. My maslaha. What benefits me? And this has become the core drive of Bani Adam, of the children of Adam, alayhi salam. Surely mankind is in a state of loss. But of course Allah chose for some to be guided, and chose and gave them the way to choose to be successful. He said, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, except for those who believe in Tawheed, in the oneness of Allah, and in His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and those who perform the righteous deeds and the good deeds, وَتَوَاصُوا بِالْحَقِّ, and they encourage and recommend one another to the truth, وَتَوَاصُوا بِالصَّبْرِ, and they recommend and encourage each other towards patience. So honestly, being truthful, we can all improve greatly on implementing these ayat of this very short surah. This is what the companions did. They would never just read the Quran and move on. They would read, and when they implemented it, then they would move on to what is next. So they can improve. We can improve on all of these things, so we're not a loser on the day of resurrection. So here we have the first point. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. We all say we believe. الإيمان تصديق القلب والقول على اللسان وعمل بالجوارح. Iman, faith, belief, is not just that you say it with your tongue. It is the belief of the belief in the heart, the statement of the tongue, and it is the actions of the limbs. لِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. To Allah belongs all the beautiful names and attributes. وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And He is the Lord of the heavens and the earth without any aid or any assistance or any fatigue. وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. And He is truly capable and powerful over all things. ولا نعبد إلا إياه. And we worship none but Him alone without partners. وحده لا شريك له. But then, if we give ourselves that we have believed, then comes إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات, the good deeds. وتواصوا بالحق, they enjoin and they encourage the truth. وتواصوا بالصبر, and they enjoin and they encourage patience. So what is this? We strike out on all three of these because none of us can do enough good. Because we're ignoring a portion of our rights that our brothers and sisters have over us, and we're ignoring that portion, we're neglecting it. وَتَوَاصُوا بِالْحَقِّ, encouraging that truth and enjoining that truth. We fail and strike out on this point, because the truth is something we're supposed to spread and recommend daily. And when the truth and the reality is so very clear to us, yet we turn the other cheek, we have failed on implementing this ayah. وَتَوَاصُوا بِالصَّبْرِ, and enjoining and encouraging a sabr, patience. And this, again, we strike out on, because we complain with what Allah chooses for us. And we don't remind those who are struggling and going through hardships with the knowledge that Allah khayrul makirin, that Allah is the best of all planners. So we are all negligent, especially on this day, in this year, and at this time. We are taught and commanded and encouraged by our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the following hadith: لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. None of you truly believes or completely believes till he loves for his brother and his sister in Islam what he loves for himself. And this hadith is sahih in the Sunan of al-Tirmidhi. We are taught and commanded and encouraged by the hadith from Abu Musa radiallahu anhu, where the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, المؤمن للمؤمن كالبنيان يشد بعضه بعضا. The believer to the believer is like a building of bricks. One part strengthens the others, and he interlaced the fingers with both his hands. The strengthening, the supporting, the aiding of one another. And we are taught and commanded and encouraged by another hadith. مثل المؤمنين في تواديهم وتراحمهم وتعاطفهم مثل الجسد إذا اشتكى منه عضوا تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. متفق عليه. And this hadith that we have in Bukhari and Muslim, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the believers in their mutual kindness to one another, their compassion for one another, their sympathy and empathy towards one another, they are just like one body. When one limb hurts or suffers, the whole body suffers from wakefulness and sleep. Even the hangnail, a piece of skin by the bed of your nail, can make your whole body irritated. That hangnail might be one brother or one sister from this ummah who is facing some hardship and difficulty. So why is the rest of the body not suffering any sleeplessness? Why is the rest of the body not suffering any aching or fever? This principle holds fast today more than ever. Why we need our masajid, why we need schools for our children to be raised up with Islamically. Because we face it, we must face it for the most part. This generation of our children, and definitely the next one, they have no hopes of going most likely to reside in the Muslim lands, for the most part. So we must be honest about this. So we owe it to Allah and to them to give them an Islamic environment while seeking their education, so they don't get those corrupt societal issues forced upon them. And they have an environment where they can be taught and weaned the hadith we just mentioned, the principles we just mentioned, to help take care of this ummah that it is that is in dire need of its body, to love one another, to support one another, to help one another, to care for one another, and to strengthen one another. But the worry is that we are not doing what we have to do with respect to the brotherhood and the sisterhood that we have as Muslims. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said in a hadith which has been graded as da'if, as not authentic, but Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he said that its meaning without a doubt is true. This hadith was, من لم يهتم بأمر المسلمين فليس منهم. That the one who is not concerned with the situations of the Muslims, then he or she is not one of them. He or she is not one of them. And this principle without a doubt is true. We have our dilemmas, my brothers and sisters in Islam. The school we want to build for our children to have that environment growing up, we should be able to build it in 1 year, just with the wealth in the Muslim, of the Muslims in this valley. But this is another situation, because we need to, whether we have that school yet or not, start implementing these foundations in our children to focus helping our brothers and sisters worldwide by teaching the future generations, our children, about brotherhood, about generosity, about charity, about responsibility to the brothers and sisters of Islam across the globe. So we have our ummah's dilemmas in addition to needing this school built, but these dilemmas are an all-time high. The third holiest site in our deen, to us Muslims, Masjid al-Aqsa, Masjid al-Aqsa in Jerusalem, the third holiest site where our Prophet ﷺ told us that one prayer there was equivalent to 250 prayers in any other masjid other than Masjid al-Haram and Masjid al-Nabawi. Other than Masjid al-Haram in Mecca and the Prophet's Masjid in Medina. Other than that, Masjid al-Aqsa, a prayer there is worth 250 prayers than any prayer in any other masjid besides those two. Yet, it is a masjid that is being bombarded, in which women and children and elderly and men have been killed and suffocated with tear gas and bombarded upon in Ramadan while worshipping their Creator at that. Not fighting, not doing anything wrong, only bowing down and prostrating to Rabbul Alameen above the heavens and the earth, separate from His creation. This is a site where our Prophet ﷺ, he was taken to when he was in a year of difficulty. He was taken to Jerusalem because it's a blessed land. In one night, on a wild beast, by Allah's permission, to give him Isra wal Mi'raj, this night journey and the ascension into Jannah. سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى الَّذِي بَارَكْنَا حَوْلَهُ لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Allah says, glorified and exalted be Allah above all that's associated with Him, who took His slave Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam for a journey at night from al-Masjid al-Haram in Mecca to Masjid al-Aqsa, the furthest masjid in Jerusalem, their neighborhood which we have blessed, in order that we might show him some of our lessons, our ayat, our proofs, our evidences, and our signs. He is the all-hearer, the all-seer. This site, Masjid al-Aqsa, was the direction of the first Qibla that the Muslims prayed to, before the Qibla was changed to the Kaaba, to Mecca. A site where many of the prophets walked through. And look at it in this past week. We have forgotten that Masjid al-Aqsa is not a Palestinian issue, and it's not an Arab issue. It is a Muslim issue, any way you want to look at it, right, left, up, down. And we ask Allah and we pray to Allah to help our brothers there and all across the world, and our sisters there all across the world, and all across the world, for the suffering they endured, and to grant us victory from those who oppress us. But this is one of those problems. You go to Afghanistan, there are Muslims being brutally and wrongfully killed, people living with no safety or security to know what will happen to them if they go out of their home that day. You go to Burma, and our brothers and sisters from the Rohingya being brutally and wrongfully killed, the women being raped, the children being tortured, the malnourishment, the hunger, the disaster that we're seeing in terms of them not even having clean water to drink. You go to China, the Uyghur Muslims in a concentration camp, something that the world promised would never happen after World War II. And they're in a concentration camp, the men with bags over their head. Some of them are being killed to get their organs out, to sell them to a different land, to someone who wants a kidney or a liver or whatever, to stay alive. So they're intentionally killing someone to take their organs and to sell them at that. The women again are being raped and detained. The children being forced to commit shirk sometimes at that, to choose something other than Islam. When we go to Syria, the devastation and the torment, children searching in the dirt for crumbs to eat. The water that they have is water that even an animal shouldn't even drink from. Once a beautiful land, a land where in the east of Damascus, Prophet Isa, Prophet Jesus alayhi salam, will come down on the wings of two angels when he is returned back to the earth at the time Dajjal is running rampant. You go to Yemen, you find one of the worst humanitarian and poverty-ridden crises around the world today, all because of war and bloodshed. You go to Kashmir, you have Muslims being brutally and wrongfully killed and tortured. You go to India, where the Hindu nationalists are killing the Muslims because they say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad al-Rasulullah. Ayn al-Mahabba ya ibadallah. Ayn al-Rahma ya ibadallah. Ayn al-Mawadda ya ibadallah. Ayn al-Dumu' ya ibadallah. Ayn al-Huzn ya ibadallah. Ayn al-Ham ya ibadallah. O servants of Allah, where is your mercy for the Ummah? Where is your love and compassion for the Ummah? Where is your tears for the Ummah? Where is your sadness for the Ummah? Where is your anxiety and concern for the Ummah? If we do not feel this concern on a daily basis, not just from the Muslims, from our family or our own lands, but for the entire Ummah, then we have a big problem. And it's not just a money thing, because a couple weeks ago, we heard something more powerful than money. We have at our disposal 24/7, and that's the dua we can make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are ignoring and ignoring and forgetting and forgetting. Why? Our hem, our concern is what car I drive, how big is my home, what brand is my purse, how nice are my clothes, what degrees hang on my wall, how much money I have in my bank account, how much land I own, and the list goes on and on. So I advise myself as we wrap it up. I advise myself and I advise you as well to look in the mirror on a daily basis, in the morning and the evening, and call yourself to account. What in my heart today came to mind, came to thought with respect to the suffering of the fellow brothers and sisters in this ummah? Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqullah wal tanzur nafsum ma qaddamat li ghadin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, O you who believe, fear Allah and keep your duty to Allah, and let every person look to what He has sent forth for tomorrow. The day where Allah will resurrect us all, on that day of resurrection, which is 50,000 years long. And guess what? There's no lying. There's no telling a false tale. Your lips will be sealed. Your arms, your thighs, your joints, everything else on your body will bear witness to what you did in your life and what you thought in this life. This will not end up good for us on the day of resurrection if we do not change now. In Allah ma yughayyiru biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. Allah will not change the good condition of a people till they change the good that's in themselves. And Allah will not change the bad situation of the people till they change the evil that is within themselves. Thabit ibn al-Hajjaj, he reported Umar ibn al-Khattab, he said, حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسُكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسِبُوا. Umar ibn al-Khattab, رضي الله عنه, he said, hold yourselves accountable before you are held accountable. Evaluate yourselves before you are evaluated. فإنه أهون عليكم في الحساب غدا أن تحاسبوا أنفسكم اليوم. He said, because it's going to be easier for you to reckon yourself and judge yourself and fix yourself now before the reckoning comes to you that day. So although this is a day of celebration, a day of Eid, a day of happiness at concluding the blessed month of Ramadan, fasting for Allah, reading the book of Allah, standing in prayer for Allah, we should carry some sadness of what's happening to our brothers and sisters in this ummah, so we can at the very least make dua for them over and over in every sajda and try to make a change. And inshallah, we will be helping our brothers and sisters with projects shortly, monetarily and in other ways. But keep that dua alive. Keep the love and the compassion for one another alive, locally amongst the brothers and sisters and worldwide. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات اللهم ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم اجعل القرآن ربيع قلوبنا ونور صدورنا وجلاء أحزاننا وذهاب همومنا اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا وسجودنا وركوعنا ودعاءنا وصدقاتنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وانصرنا على أعدائك وأعداء الدين يا أرحم الراحمين سبحان ربك رب العزة أما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا واهدنا وارزقنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين عيدكم مبارك تقبل الله منا ومنكم وكل عام وأنتم بخير اختارنا مبارك شاف Have a blessed day. Let the children come, grab some donuts. We have some Eid money gifts for them if they want to come and see me, inshallah. And there's some bags of candy for the children to take as well. Have a blessed Eid and remember the Ummah in your dua. Barakallahu feekum wa jazakumullahu khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.